Next one is IOC. That will be the last one. Then we will end the session today. And I am going to use this area to buy in cash only, because it's a monthly and weekly demand zone. So it will take its own time. And futures means you just have to hold it. And any small 2-3 rupee move will show us negative M2M, which is going to play with our mindset further, isn't it? Breach of demand zone is a higher thing, correct? Yes. Okay. And I'm not concerned about this drop, base drop, unless it breaks this demand zone. Then we have a credible supply. So now if this demand zone breaches, we come inside here. So this is the best point, which Venkat mentioned about 105 rupees. That's a point only from where probably it is going to turn. But as it comes down, it is going to break one weekly demand zone and come lower. So because of which the trend is going to shift to sideways. But that you can see from where the whole thing shifted, isn't it here? That's a daily demand zone. Yeah. So since this is within the monthly, the first monthly demand zone, and it's a TCP on the daily, first cash position allowed. Now these are stacked one above the other. Now, if you're interested, you can buy it here also, but we know the EMA is still below lower. So we will make this. Because the overall market trend is also down, right? So there are chances that this might just keep pushing it down, go in, make more base candles. One, the best thing would be it comes down like this here, and then we have a novice gap down into this area of demand zone. A novice gap down into this area, and next day a pro gap, you are assured of a trend change then. Like how Bank Nifty and ICICI did at that point in time. Right, so it may come halt here. Next day we may have a gap down, novice gap down, and you will see a base kind of candle formation. That's when you pick up your first small position. And if we have a next day gap up and it sustains, you will have a daily TCP formed. Then you start getting into the remaining position at that point in time. And definitely the daily TCP will be formed, which will take off this supply here. So you are still getting in below 110, 111. And then this is going to be your target one. Maybe somewhere in the middle, you can plan for target one. But cash, if somebody is interested, that is going to be your target two, because this is also a pro gap. Yes, this is a dividend date, dividend thing. Okay, which may further push it down. So be... have patience. And if it goes up from here, maybe once we start going beyond this is when you will start having your confirmations on the daily chart as well. If let's say this demand holds, it doesn't come here. Then once it goes beyond 121, then you start going long at around 118, 115, and target will be the same. Yeah, I know you look. I understood what it's nothing wrong. So I said, you can take at 112, 111 as your first entry point, which is fine. See, when you do in cash, I will not bother you. It's only when you do in futures is when I'll start questioning you. Because 2-3 rupees se jab 150 target hai, to 112 mein lo ya 114 mein lo, koi farak nahi padta. Yes, after confirmation, after TCP, then you are allowed to trade in futures. Because the trend will shift.